Turning now to some new details tonight on a plan to house 1,000 homeless people in Denver by the end of this year. Denver Mayor Mike Johnston announcing how the city will actually pay for this, and it won't come at a cost to the city's critical services, but the plan is not appeasing everyone. FOX 31's Vicente Arenas is on that story this afternoon. He's live at the City and County Building. Hi, Vicente.
Hi there, Talia. So the mayor gave us a lot of details about where this money is going to come from. He talked about where the money would come from to pay for tiny homes and for pallet boxes, but not everybody's happy with the plan.
Today, the mayor said the priority is to help homeless people abandon encampments and transition into more stable housing.
The plan is fully paid for. We have a path to success on that plan.
Mayor Mike Johnston said the total cost, $48.6 million. $18.9 million would be used to purchase and operate the Best Western Hotel. $5.4 million would be used for leases and operations at additional hotels. $19.6 million for micro communities. $4 million for leased units. And $750,000 for encampment response. The money would come from an existing budget that focuses on housing issues and homelessness, as well as federal dollars. No key critical services, Johnston said, would be cut. The mayor said the use of hotels and micro communities filled with tiny homes and pallet homes would be safer for the entire community.
In the last calendar year, all of 2022 combined, we had a micro community that had a total of 3 service calls to 911.
Still, there's been some pushback from people who live near one of the proposed sites at 5500 East Yale Avenue near I-25 South. Some say they're concerned about increased traffic where there are already too many accidents. Encampments, they say, have already been creating problems for some time. Alec Baker says this community does support an initiative to help those in need, but this neighborhood is on edge.
We've been dealing with some of the kind of neighborhood consequences of the housing crisis. We don't necessarily trust that the city is going to follow through on its initiatives and look after our specific safety.
And Baker also tells us that he feels the whole process has been rushed. Meantime, the mayor says there are still specific sections of that budget that have to be approved by the city council. At the City County Building, live, I'm Vicente Arenas, FOX 31.
All right, Vicente, thank you.